Well, good morning, and thank you for having me. It's really good to be with you again. And I wanted to take just a minute to introduce my family. I have with me here my wife, Amy, and my daughter, Sarah. And one of the things when you contemplate running for a statewide office is you take stock of your family, and we happen to be very blessed, and I feel very fortunate that we are in a strong enough position to run this race. Amy is fabulous. And not only that, but she was an ICU nurse and an inner city emergency room nurse, and she knows how the world works. My daughter Sarah here just graduated from the University of Minnesota in chemical engineering and has a job as an R&D engineer. Our other two kids, my oldest Hannah, works for a conservative think tank proposing private property and market-based solutions to conservation, believe it or not. And my youngest son, Michael, is a sophomore in college right now. And so we feel really blessed, and I may be a little biased, but compared to Mark Dayton and his dogs, don't you think we make a wonderful first family? So Amy and I, as we talked about running for governor, decided that we would be bold, and that I would say exactly what I think, and we would take on the entrenched special interests, that we would not back down from the very beginning of this campaign, and that we would run a strong statewide campaign, because we cannot produce a candidate after our endorsement that is not equipped to run statewide. And so that's what I've been trying to do on the campaign trail, and I hope you've seen it. This campaign is about key issues for the state of Minnesota. We need to make the state work for everyone. You go into the urban core and you talk to a family where the school isn't safe and the kids don't graduate. You go out on the Iron Range and you talk to somebody who just wants the mines approved and the pipelines. You talk to farmers who just want the MPCA and the DNR off their back. And you realize that across this state, Minnesota isn't working for everyone right now. And we have a chance in this election, as Republicans, to actually change that. And our candidate will carry that flag. Many of you have followed, I've got policy positions on the chairs, and you've been reading about them. We have the ideas that will work. We can change the business climate in Minnesota. We can change state government, make it smaller, cheaper, and better. We do that, we can actually offer a 15% reduction in state spending and a $7 billion tax refund to people. We can offer vouchers so the families trapped in those failing schools can get out of them. We can actually really repeal MNGOP. Not bail it out for another 2 years until we kill it later. Let's do it now. We have the ideas I have always talked in my career in business, my career in the legislature, my time at the state party about fixing things, but I gotta tell you, this election is not gonna be won that way. I had a woman at the state fair come up to my booth right across the street, came right up to me, and she started telling me about her circumstances. Two small businesses she had lost. She lived in St. Paul, the taxes, the regulations were killing her. Obamacare came along. She lost her two small businesses. And by the time she was done, she had tears in her eyes. And she said to me, "Will you fight for me?" 8 years of politics, no one has ever said that to me before. I didn't quite know what to say. She said, "If you fight for me, guess what? There are so many of us out here, and we will be with you." That is what this election is about, people. Who among these candidates can go and run a statewide campaign, appeal to the people across this state, show them that we are on their side? You know, Republicans are on the side of the little guy in this election. We are. We have a chance to go out and pitch that message in a positive way, fundamentally conservative, fundamentally on the side of the people. But I gotta tell you, it's gonna be tough. It will be really tough. I offered a couple of proposals when I was in the legislature about reforming government. And this is what happens. Trust me, it happens. Thank you.
Are we going to stand for that?
No!
Welcome to Downeyville. Do you enjoy it here?
No!
Downeyville is the kind of place that turns its back on the poor, on the sick, on the children, on the elderly.
That's what's coming our way, people, in this election. That's it. Are we going to be strong enough?
Yeah.
You going to fight hard for the people of Minnesota?
Yeah.
Me too. And you know what? By the time I get down to the Capitol in St. Paul, we will have traveled the state and pitched a very positive, fundamentally conservative message for the people of this state. They will be at our back. We will have a chance to lead. We will have a chance to govern according to our principles. And when I step up to the microphone in February of 2019 and deliver our State of the State speech, I'm going to look the people of Minnesota right in the eye, through the lens of that camera, and tell them, this is for you. We told you what we were going to do. We're going to do it. We're going to deliver for the people of Minnesota. No more excuses. I'm Keith Downey. I'd love to be your candidate for governor.